Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. This is your host Prajwal, and in today's video we're gonna look at how to use ZigZag Exchange on ZKSync. So let's get started. Just a quick disclaimer that none of the things mentioned in this video is or should be taken as a financial advice. Always do your own research and never blindly follow anything that is mentioned in these kinds of videos. All of these videos are made for educational purposes and also to share whatever I've learned, and none of this is financial advice. Once we have that out of the way, if this video was helpful or is helpful, please leave a like, as that helps the channel a lot, and subscribe for more videos. And if you run into any issues or if you have any questions regarding this or any other projects, please leave them in the comments below. I've made a couple of videos on ZKSync in the past talking about the airdrop and how you can probably make yourself eligible for the airdrop, but we don't know that yet, or maybe we've already missed the window. But this new exchange called ZigZag.exchange is fairly new. It's been out for about a week or more, and they don't have a token yet, and the possibility that they might have an airdrop in the future is quite high. As you know, the DYDX had a huge airdrop to its users or its community that used the exchange, which was on Starknet. And ZigZag.exchange is actually one of the first order book exchange on ZKSync, so it's cheap to use, and I would definitely do some trades on it just to see how this thing works and also possibly make myself eligible for the airdrop if there is one in the future. First, what you need to do is you need to transfer some funds from your layer 1 to layer 2. So from layer 1 Ethereum mainnet to ZKSync layer 2 rollup, basically, right? Now, I use wallet.zksync.io to transfer my funds from layer 1 to layer 2. If there are other bridges or protocols that do the same thing at a cheaper price, please let me know in the comments below so that I can update the tutorial in the future. So what you need to do is go to wallet.zksync.io and click on Ethereum wallet, click on MetaMask. Mind you, this will cost you some money, as in some gas fees, and also you need to have some extra funds to do the transactions and stuff. At the moment, I have ETH, USDC, USDT, not much of USDT, USDT. So I've already bridged around $100 to layer 2 ZKSync. But if you are doing this for the first time, you'll probably see something like this, where it says add funds, no balances yet. So you got to do is click on add funds, and you can also buy crypto with RAMP if that's something you're looking into. But if you already have some funds on layer 1 or your MetaMask sitting there, you can just select that, select token. It's showing me nothing at the moment, but select ETH and then add funds and send it through. Now, mind you, it does cost you around $20 to $30 a minimum for the transaction fee, so please bear that in mind before you go and use these kinds of services. After the funds are transferred, you will see them here. It'll probably take 10-15 minutes. Sometime it takes half an hour as well. So what you want to do is go to trade.zigzag.exchange. And as you can see, there's an option to connect wallet. There's three different networks. Previously there was no Starknet, but now Starknet is also there. I'll probably make another guide on how to use the Starknet network. But if you want to use the Rinkaby, which is actually a testnet, you don't need real funds trade on the Rinkaby network. You can basically request for the faucet funds, which is actually just a play money, test money kind of situation. I'll leave a link to the Twitter account or the Twitter post that they've posted step by step on how to do that. I'm not going to go through that in this video, as this video probably will be very long if I go through that process again. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to trade on the mainnet, ZKSync mainnet, connect wallet, sign that. And as you can see, the wallet has been connected. And another thing is, there's not many assets that you can trade on ZigZag Exchange at the moment. You can trade ETH basically, or USDT slash USDC. You can convert them, or you can buy and sell ETH to USDC or USDT and vice versa. For every trade, you pay a dollar amount. As regardless of how big or how small the trade is, you're going to pay a dollar for the trade. It was very low when they started on the first day or the second day, but I think because of the amount of transactions and the amount of people using this exchange is ridiculous. And also there was a rumor that they will probably do an airdrop, so I think that's another reason why people are using this a lot. And also taking inspiration from DYDX's airdrop, people are speculating that this will probably do a big airdrop. Now, no one knows if there probably will be an airdrop, the scale that they're going to do an airdrop. You cannot place a limit order on ZKSync at the moment. All the orders at the moment are market ordered. There's no limit order. So there's an option to limit order, but what happens is if you click on it, So as you can see, it says limit orders disabled on ZKSync, so you'll have to market order. I have a little bit of ETH, so what I'm going to do is you can sell it to USDT or USDC, depending on what you prefer. So I'm going to sell my ETH at 4,456. At the moment, as you can see, it's at 60, so that's fine. I'm going to sell it and sign it. As you can see, fee is 0.0003 ETH. Was rejected, not enough balance. Now, as you can see, it says this happens occasionally. You run the transaction again, you must should be fine. So this happens a lot. This is still, they're still trying things out. They're still fixing things and stuff. So this is bound to happen. You probably will need to place the trade again and sign it. Don't worry, you're not going to be charged, I think. All right, so it says, see, it's still the same. I'm going to cancel that again. And I'm going to try again. This is working better yesterday when I was trying it out, but for some reason this seems to have a lot of issues. Rejected, not enough balance. So maybe there's not enough balance on ZKSync or on the ZigZag exchange at the moment to trigger this order. Try again. Sign. All right, so we're going to let me try and sell maybe 25%. And see if they have enough funds for that. 25. You can also see your trades here. So I just placed an order for $25 at 4453.90. Committing. So this probably might go through because it's a small order. As you can see, the sell order for this was filled. All right. So as you can see, the spread is a bit high. So you're paying 4462. Be selling for 4453. So keep that in mind as well. Don't place very big orders in hope of getting an airdrop, which we don't know if there will be one, but it's nice to projects being rolled out on layer 2 and not charging you an arm and a leg for the transactions, right? Hope that was helpful. If you have any questions or if you have any queries, leave them in the comments below and subscribe, and you have a nice day. Thank you.